the mayor of Omaha has no authority whatsoever to press charges.
You have a lot of power. No, you have a lot of power. That maybe lies, not to press criminal charges, but to stand in solidarity with our protest. You can stand up and speak out that there should be charges.
You have to let him talk out about it. Talk out about it.
Use your voice. Use your voice.
The investigation is not
complete.
It's not complete. It's not complete.
I'm here to listen to you.
No, you're not.
Yesterday, one of my friends that I work with was called by you. You said a troll hiding behind symbols.
Yes, you did.
I have the screenshot right now. I have the screenshot right now.
We all saw that.
I was responding to someone on Facebook saying that I was showing no leadership. I was a coward. I was responding to it.
And you call him out? You're going to say symbols? That's fucking
weird.
He is a great American. And he came out about you people. No, you said symbols to support me. That's fucking racist. Just like Pete Ricketts said, you people.
You know what?
Unacceptable.
Here's what I came out to tell you. I came out to tell you that I support what you're doing. No, I want to tell you.
Listen. Give them justice.
I want to tell you that I know what is in your heart. And what is in your heart is you want to be listened to. And I came out to listen to
you.
I want to let you know this. I, as mayor, I have no authority to press charges. I never have. I never will.
Tell the police to lay down their pants.
Listen, that is with the county attorney. That's Don Klein. He is an elected official,
too. Yeah. Well, tell him to put down the tear gas. Stop shooting rubber bullets.
I don't have a voice.
I am fucking away with murder.
I am here to listen to you.
I'm saying I can't talk. It doesn't
matter. I'm here to listen to you right now.
We need to be control of ours.
No,
I am.
She said no. I just offered this. She said no. You're refusing this.
Here's the thing. The only thing that can solve the injustice that is happening right now is if that elected officials step down right now and admit that they have failed their country and admit that injustice has happened. That's what we require. I'm sorry, but that's it.
If we're going to solve this, listen.
This doesn't even deserve to be at those ugly ass feet.
If
we're going to solve this, we've got to work together.
Say his name.
And we're asking him to work. We're emotional. Why will we charge for standing on the sidewalk immediately and give him a shot?
I'm going to listen to you, okay?
Flex a little bit. So I think what people want to know, hi, Mr. Mayor.
Hi, how are you?
I'm well, thanks. I'm Joaquin Fox with the White Family Foundation. I think what people are asking here when they talk about Black Lives Matter and your impact on what can happen in the city, your city that you're running.
Right.
What is your opportunity or your persuasion to have on police officers, on the National Guard, to treat people with kindness, as you said that you want to listen, and they're saying we're protesting for our voices to be heard, but they're being shot at the same time. So what's your opportunity to calm some of those interactions? Because it has been police and National Guard that have instigated those opportunities. And we know you're not directly involved in the prosecution, but what's your opportunity to impact some of those? And when can we hear a statement from you on how you will do that?
You know, I mean, that's what I've been done three press conferences in 3 days, because what I wanted people to know is we encourage peaceful protests. That's what we want to hear from you. I know everybody's heart is hurting. We want to try to figure out what we can do to make it better. I will tell you this. I feel like our police department has made, and you live in Omaha, great strides in the last 6 years to improve community relations. However, we have said that we will always, we always want to be better.
So we always want to improve. Specifics aligned with that currently.
Well, let me ask you this.
We want to hear a little bit about that.
Let me ask you this. It would be so much easier if we could set up a time and to have the police, to have the chief and me with me, and to sit down and have a conversation to say, what can we do?
And but what you're hearing right now is that people don't feel comfortable with those scenarios.
But
because
right now you're
here with us, and you have an opportunity to answer some of those questions right now.
But here's what's so difficult. This has been a problem, and as you know that, for decades. If the solution was easy, we wouldn't be standing here.
We're not saying it's easy.
You know, it's going to be really hard, and what we are willing to do, and we are willing to do that, we are willing to work with you and listen to you and try to figure out what we can do to make it better. And I think you know that. I think you've known me long enough that I'm in that. I will sit down with anybody. I'll talk. I'll listen.
And if we can make it better, we will. I have been on the mayor's advisory board before, so that's how we know each other. Full transparency. But I don't think you've spoken directly to the question that has been asked today. What's your opportunity to calm the National Guard and police as they have been brutalized?
Our hands up running.
Which are getting
if we would continue to have peaceful protests.
Peaceful protests.
This is all going to be
peaceful.
Hold on, you guys. We do want this to go away. We do want this to go away, but currently in City Council, they will be asking for an extension on the state of emergency.
No, just a state of emergency.
Which is
and it's just in the,
for another week.
The other, yeah, it's
does
just
that
for
mean,
another
does,
week.
Is that not, that doesn't have anything to do with curfew? Yeah.
That is at the request of the police chief.
Okay.
Just in case they need.
What's your thought?
My
mayors do.
My thought to do that? I don't want a curfew.
People are watching you.
I've never wanted a curfew.
On this. And I think
it felt like that this was important to get it calmed down. That's what the chief is
what
asking.
What you always want to do is calm black folks down.
No, it's not.
Yeah, tear but gas them, shoot kids.
What we
want
to address is that it's not the public that needs to be calm.
That's extraordinary.
We're not the aggressors.
What do you want to do?
There's people in this crowd that
I would love
from peacefully protesting. We're tired. Look at this. Look at this.
Would you like to get the leaders to come and talk?
We can organize. Not today. Not today. I don't know if these aren't the leaders. They're here to voice their support for Black Lives Matter.
Let's do that.
And I think with those city meetings, I think you need to diversify your options because you talk to a really old guard. And I think you need to increase the diversity of those conversations.
You know, I'll agree with
because they don't represent the entire black community.
Right.
And you need to diversify that.
And you know, yesterday when we had that meeting, there was a lot of, well, not a lot, but there was, I would say there was three or four younger people that really represented the black community.
Yeah, I know Jasmine Harris, I know Precious McKeeson, and they were upset.
Leo
Lewis, and they were upset by the governor's comments. They were very upset by those.
And he misspoke, and he did.
Come
he apologized
on,
for it.
So we need.
So we will.
This is a time when we can get direct comment about your support for Black Lives because people are dying in the street, and a person went uncharged.
We do. We absolutely do. And we have made. And you know, we have made a lot of progress and a lot of strides. I don't do the investigations.
But you have sway.
No, I don't. No, there's. Listen.
You're the
there's. Listen. I have no authority.
What do mayors do?
The mayor of this city is the executive branch, so I can't override. I can't override the judicial, and I can't override the legislative. So what they do over in that courthouse, Don Klein, he is the prosecutor. What he does over there, I can't override.
This is on TV and condemn it.
But listen, perhaps that's where you should be.
People are inside talking to
you, and there will be opportunity to talk to Don Klein. But you do have opportunity to say,
Mayor Stothert, this is your moment.
In something else.
This is your moment. Do not mess it up. Do not mess this up. You already slipped up once online. Right now, you are in person. People are watching you. This is your moment.
I have an opportunity.
This is your moment.
I came out here to listen to you and to tell you I support what you're doing.
Don't tell us what you're doing. Your actions tell us what you're doing.
Tell the
actions speak louder than words.
And I will promise you, we will do everything we can with your help and your summit. You're working with me at how we can further improve police community relations and relations.
I have a question. I have a genuine, calm question. Can I ask a genuine, calm question?
Same thing.
I truly am nonviolent. I have been a vegetarian, gay, hippie my entire life.
I appreciate that.
I was standing on 72nd and Dodge at 6:20 at the evening on the sidewalk, nonviolently, with arms linked. I asked the officers multiple times what law I was breaking, why freedom of assembly didn't apply, and instead, at point blank range, I was shot with pepper pellets. I was multiple times.
Me too.
Beaten with batons, thrown on the ground in the street by three officers, not resisting. And I had one put his knee on my back, close to my neck, as almost like an homage to what has happened to other people. I need you to recognize that the experience we have had has been traumatic.
I recognize that.
I need you to speak out on it then. Mm-hmm. Please condemn Don Klein. Please do something. Make a statement. You have a voice here. That is the point. We don't have a platform. This is the most platform I'll ever get in my life, and it's small. You have a large platform.
You've got a platform now in front of the mayor.
That's what I'm saying. But this is it.
And it's on this here. Listen.
Us in Omaha.
And I'm here to listen to you. What can what
so yeah. Take
please action. Tell yeah. them they have to tell us what laws we're breaking, what time, or like, you know, there was no warning. There was no warning. I have never had something like that happen.
No, I understand. It was probably.
I don't think you do. You weren't there.
Curfew is unconstitutional.
I shot at people with our hands up.
So I can't answer your individual question. But I will say this, what I saw, it was truly the three darkest days I've ever seen in the city of Omaha. It was heartbreaking to see what was going on. And I'm sorry that happened to
It's dark every day for black Americans.
Well, but we got to fix it. We need to fix it. And I will guarantee if it can start with me, I'll do everything in my power.
Except condemn him. Just condemn him. It's a phrase, man.
If you are,
that's all it takes.
I would be
we did yesterday. We peaced
right out.
The police took a knee with us last night and then gassed us.
That's exactly
what I did.
You're doing the same thing.
You're doing the same thing right
now. That's the same thing right now. This is a photo op, y'all. This is a photo op.
You guys have to know what you're asking for. And that's not happening right now.
I support a peaceful protest. That's what you're doing. I'm out here to tell you that. And I'm
sorry if I'm doing it wrong.
No, you're not. And I know you got a lot of emotions and you feel like you've been betrayed. And I'm here to tell you, whatever I can do to help, I will.
Say Black Lives Matter. You could do that right now.
Black Lives Matter.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Tomorrow.
Be a good
thank you.
I'll go do something.
All right.
I'm going in and do something.
And we will. Okay.
All right. Don't leave, y'all. Let's talk.
All right. We'll talk soon.
Sure.
Okay.
Sure.
I promise you that.
I appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Of course.
Thank you.
We have opportunities.
Where's the guy that was hit?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll make
sure.
Officer, thank you for coming. Sorry, officer.
All right.